For the root test, the conclusions look very similar to when we did the ratio test. The major difference is how you set up your limit. In these, we're going to take the limit as n goes to infinity of the nth root of our absolute value of the a sub n term from our series. Less than 1 is convergent, greater than 1 or infinity is divergent, and equal to 1 is inconclusive. Those punchlines were the same with ratio test, but instead of absolute value of a sub n plus 1 over a sub n, we take the nth root of our a sub n term. Let's jump to some examples. Determine the convergence or divergence of the series using that should say root test. I'm going to have to fix that in my notes, so I apologize for that. Happens to the best of us, I suppose. Okay, so we have our a sub n term is 1 over n to the n. Let's set up this limit. So we have limit as n goes to infinity, nth root absolute value of 1 over n to the n. Well, this fraction, because 1 to the n is still 1, I'm actually going to write it as 1 fraction to the nth power. Well, that nth root and nth power will cancel one another. It's like square rooting a square or cube rooting a cube. They're going to cancel one another, leaving the limit as n goes to infinity, absolute value of 1 over n, that goes to 0. And because that is less than 1, this series is convergent by the root test. Our next example, we have the sum from 0 to infinity of e to the 2n over n to the n. Let's set up our limit and apply the root test. We're going to go limit as n goes to infinity, nth root of our a sub n term in absolute values. Since the numerator and denominator both have an n in the exponent, I'm going to rewrite that as e squared over n to the nth power. Remember, applying exponent properties, that would still be 2n and n to the n power. It's just easier if we can get that exponent out, then the nth root of the nth power will cancel, leaving limit as n goes to infinity of e squared over n. E squared is a constant. If n keeps growing, this fraction goes to 0. That's less than 1, so by root test, this infinite series converges. And then our last example we did in class for root test, we have the sum from 1 to infinity of negative 3n over 2n plus 1 to the 3n power. Setting up our limit, we have limit as n goes to infinity of the nth root absolute value of our a sub n term, 3 to the n as our power. So be very careful when you write this in here. Now, absolute value eventually is going to make this term positive. We'll get to it at the end. The nth root, nth power, those cancel. So we are left with the limit as n approaches infinity of absolute value, negative 3n over 2n plus 1. As n gets really large, oh, and don't forget that power of 3 that did not get canceled, only the n's. We have matching powers of n, they're both n to the first, so we take the lead coefficients, that's negative 3 halves. Absolute value is positive 3 halves. When we cube, we get something larger than 1. That tells us we have a divergent series by the root test.